Examination of the fundus of the eye of preterm infants in skin-to-skin contact and with principles from the Newborn Individualized Developmental Care and Assessment Program. This is Julia. She was born extremely preterm in week 25 in 2 days with a birth weight of 615 grams. At the time of the examination, she had a corrected age of 37 gestational weeks and weighed 2,165 grams. This video was made together with Julia's mother Erica and father Hampus. Julia's mother and father shared their photos, film and experience for the best possible support for infants in need of eye examinations and their parents. As parents, you are your infant's safe base and security. Together with you, we make thorough plans for your infant's care. Well in advance of the eye examination, detailed information is given about why it needs to be done, when it's planned, how it's done, and how you can provide the best support for your infant. We ensure optimal conditions with a calm atmosphere where disturbing noise, light, activity, nursing, and procedures are kept to a minimum before, during, and after the examination. Diaper changes and meals are well planned and adjusted in time to fit the examination. Skin-to-skin contact is encouraged well in advance of the examination, preferably so that the previous meal is given in skin-to-skin contact. As a parent, you help your infant to feel safe and comfortable through your body, hands, voice, and scent by being supported in lying comfortably and relaxed. With support for the feet and with hands close to the face, your infant feels safe. A tube binder or similar is helpful for both the infant, the parent and the staff. It allows for undisturbed, safe and secure skin-to-skin contact before, during and after the examination. It is also important that you as a parent have a good support for a comfortable position and that you are prepared to have your infant in skin-to-skin contact for a long time. The infant is given pupil dilating eye drops about 45 minutes and often also 30 minutes before the examination. We help the infant to wake up calmly by approaching cautiously. In the face of a change, your infant will gain strength from hearing your voice, getting help to grasp with one or both hands, sucking on a pacifier and tasting milk in their mouth. Here Julia got a sweet solution, sugar. Both milk and sugar have been shown to have pain-relieving effects. A few minutes before the actual fundus photography, we make sure to give sugar solution for pain-relieving purposes. Milk in the mouth is often repeated as this, together with other positive experiences, divert the infant from the stress of the examination. Touch the face gently before slightly pulling down the lower eyelid. The eye drop should end up in the lower lid crease. The edges of the eyelid are held apart for 3 to 4 seconds and excess medication in the eye is collected with a cleansing wipe to reduce the amount of medication that reaches the stomach via the tear duct and throat. Support the infant's head with minimum possible pressure to the head, preferably with a blanket in between instead of bare hands, as this seems to be more comfortable for the infant. After receiving the eye drops, your infant is sensitive to light. The infant is given time for undisturbed rest. When the ophthalmologist arrives, the final preparations are made. The placement of equipment and personnel is well planned and accessible. If the infant has support for their breathing, this is retained during the procedure. The infant is approached cautiously as before. Sugar solution in the mouth is offered a minute or two before the actual examination. We use an eyelid depressor to keep the infant's eye open. This may look scary. The eyelid depressor provides accessible images to be acquired and shortens the moment of the actual photography with the bright light directed into the eye. What we think is the most difficult for the infant is the bright light from the fundus camera. An anesthetic and protected gel are dripped into the eye before the camera is placed on the eye and images are taken at different angles. Together with your parents, we observe the infant's behaviors. If possible, both parents can help. We always make sure that there is a staff member to support you as well. Keep your hands still and support your infant in a comfortable flex position. the tube binder is a good aid. Between the examination of the first and second eye, a repeated dose of sugar solution or milk is given in the mouth and the infant is allowed time to regain balance. If the infant shows signs of strain, we pause for a moment. Such behaviors can be breathing faster or more irregularly, having an elevated heart rate, turning red in color, twitching, hiccups, fussing or grunting, squirming and stretching, fingers playing or fisting, or becoming agitated. Our mission is to avoid behaviors of instability such as paleness, spitting up, low tone with drooping chin and limp arms and legs, or declining oxygenation and respiratory pauses.
Hey.
Julia had an eye examination a few weeks before when she received support for her breathing with the CPAP. This is how a CPAP can be held during an eye examination in skin-to-skin contact. Afterwards, the ophthalmologist usually shows the images, explains, and sets up a plan for the following examinations. Together with you, we reflect on what went well during the procedure and what recommendations can be considered next time to increase the infant's well-being. The best thing for your infant after the examination is to remain undisturbed in skin-to-skin contact with you for a long time.